personal exhibition of the Italian sculptor and designer Stefano Roselli.
Siccome rota chi ugualmente è mossa, l'amor che muove il sole e l'altre stelle.
We are inside the castle of the Counts Guidi in Tuscany, not far from Caprese, the birthplace of Michelangelo Buonarroti. As we know from reliable documentation, this 13th century building has hosted, among others, the peerless poet Dante Alighieri. The exhibition entitled Silence, Look, Listen and Think brings sculptural works together with photographic images that provide the visitor with a key to their iconographic interpretation. My aim here is to create a direct, free and limpid relationship between the architectural space and that of the sculptures. I have not given titles or written descriptions of the works precisely because I want to leave total imaginative freedom to their viewers so that as they enter this magical environment, essentially intimate, personal sensations and emotions are aroused. The idea is to bring about a harmonious, respectful interaction between the space of ancient architecture and that of contemporary sculpture in order to produce striking visual effects and an atmosphere where silence is paramount and words would be merely a noisy distraction for those who want to observe, listen and think. All the sculptures are made from ecological acrylic resin and fiberglass, using special technical processes that give their structure great strength and extreme lightness. This makes it possible to exhibit them in particularly unusual positions, including hanging them from above. In the course of my professional career, I have never made single pieces. My sculptures are produced in multiple copies, sometimes as many as 20 numbered and certified exemplars. This is because I believe that no two sculptures can ever actually be identical, since each is made unique by the specific interaction between the space of the sculpture and the architectural space in which it is presented.
nelle mie sculture io non eseguo mai dei pezzi unici, ma sempre dei multipli.
Each of these works, even if identical, changes according to the space in which it is shown,
thereby producing quite a different intimate emotional impact. In fact, when I look at them in my laboratory, perhaps temporarily stacked on the floor, I get the impression of seeing dead, useless, and significant objects. But when I exhibit them in specific locations, they come to life, acquiring their full expressive energy and potential. In conclusion, I believe that a certain kind of sculpture can contain within itself an intense emotional power, which is capable of transforming the environments in which we all live into sites of fundamental aesthetic, cultural, and social value.